We're going to go over how to solve absolute value equations. First, here's the definition for absolute value. The absolute value of x represents the distance from x to 0 on the number line. All right, so x is some number, let's say. So let's say we wanted to get the absolute value of negative 2. So here's negative 2 right here. And if we just count the spaces to 0, that's our answer. It's 2 spaces away, so the absolute value of negative 2 is 2. All right, what if we wanted to do the absolute value of positive 2? Well, here's positive 2, and if we count how far away 2 is from 0, hey, it's also 2 spaces away. So the absolute value of 2 is also 2. Now, since we're talking about distance, keep in mind that you can't get a negative number, right? So if I count spaces, you can't count a negative, you can't say that's negative. So the absolute value cannot be negative, but could it be zero? What's the absolute value of zero? Well, here's zero, it's right on itself, and so how far is zero from zero? It's zero. So keep in mind, the absolute value of something cannot be negative. All right, now here's the next interesting thing. Notice that when I took the absolute value of negative 2, I got 2, and when I took the absolute value of positive 2, I also got 2. So what if an equation had been solve the absolute value of x equals 2? There's a couple ways you might think about this. One is you could just think of a number line, and you could say, all right, I want x to be 2 spaces away from 0 because the absolute value of x means how far is x from 0. So if I go 2 spaces away from 0 to the right, I'll get an answer, and 2 spaces to the left. 2 spaces away, this gets me at 2, also gives me at negative 2. So that's one way of figuring out that there are two solutions here. So if I were going to solve this, I'm going to have two solutions by looking at the picture. X could be negative 2 or x could be positive 2. Another way is you might remember my note up here, the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, and also the absolute value of 2 is 2. You might just remember that. Well, there's always two numbers that when you take the absolute value, you get 2. Another way you might think about it is this way. Whatever's inside of here, which in case that can either be 2 or it could be negative 2, right? So that when I take the absolute value, I get 2. So whatever's in here could be what's over on the right-hand side, which is 2, or it could be its opposite, which could be negative 2. And this is how you would write that down. Whatever's in there, which is x, it could either just equal the 2 or it could be the opposite of 2 to make it true. Now, that's the correct solution. It could be 2 or it could be negative 2, just like I had written over here by looking at the picture. But we want to check our answer in and make sure we're really right. This is an obvious one, but I'm going to check it because not everyone's going to be quite so obvious. So I'm going to check x equals 2 into the original problem, right? Solve absolute value of x equals 2. And I'm going to plug in 2 for x and simplify the left-hand side, simplify the right-hand side, there was nothing to do, and that's how I know for sure that's a solution. And then I'm going to check the second solution into the original, and I'm going to plug in negative 2 in for x, simplify it, absolute value of negative 2 is 2, on the right-hand side, nothing to simplify, it's already 2, and that's how I know x equals negative 2 is another solution. All right, try this problem. Absolute value of x equals 4. Solve for x. Again, you could do this by looking at a number line and figuring it out, right? If you're going to go 4 spaces to the right and 4 spaces to the left, notice you'll either end up on negative 4 or 4. So those are going to be the solutions. Or You can take the equation as it is, and to get rid of the absolute value, you say, well, whatever's in that absolute value x, that could either equal 4 or it could equal negative 4. So the solution here, hopefully you got this, you could either have 4 as a solution or negative 4 as a solution. Two ways of getting there. And I'm not going to do the check on this one. It's pretty obvious if you put in 4 for x or you put negative 4 for x, the original problem will be true. So let's come up with a way of solving it if it's not quite so obvious. How about if instead of just an x in there, I had, maybe an x minus 1 was equal to 5. And I wonder what x could be. Well, you could do this on a number line. You could say, well, I know if I go 5 spaces to the right, that's what x minus 1 could be, right? Or if I go 5 spaces to the left, that's where x minus 1 could be. So, well, if I go 5 spaces to the right, we know that number is really just the number 5, right? And if I go 5 spaces to the left, I know it's really negative 5. I really have two equations here. This x minus 1 could either equal negative 5 or it could equal positive 5. So x minus 1, by looking at the picture, could either equal 5 or x minus 1 could equal negative 5. So we could solve these by adding 1 to both sides. X is 6. It's one possibility. And if I add 1 over here, my other equation, I get x equals negative 4. So you know what? This original problem, it's got two different solutions, 6 or negative 4. Notice it's not just 6 and negative 6. You don't get to just solve one equation. There are two completely different equations. Now, you may not want to have to draw a picture to figure that out each time. So another way of thinking about it is this. Well, whatever's in here could either equal this number 5, right? Or whatever's in here could equal a negative 5. And that's exactly what I wrote. Whatever is in there, the x minus 1 could equal 5, or whatever's in there, it could be the opposite. Because if whatever was in there was equal to, this could either equal 5 or negative 5, so that when I took the absolute value, I would get a positive 5. So we could see graphically, those of you who are visual want to see it on a graph, or you could sort of think of it algebraically, whatever's in here, if it was a 5, we would get a solution, or if whatever was in here was a negative 5, when you took the absolute value, you would also get 5. Now let's go ahead and check each of these in the original problem. So I'm going to do it. I'm going to check x equals 6 into the original problem, which is absolute value of x minus 1 equals 5. So we're going to plug in 6 for x. And that gives me the absolute value of 5. And when you simplify that, you get 5. So definitely it looks like 6 is correct. And now we're going to check negative 4 in for x. So we're going to do, whoops, we're going to plug in negative 4 for x. Simplify inside the absolute value. And I got 5 on the left-hand side, 5 on the right. So negative 4 is another solution to this problem. So those are the two solutions, 6 and negative 4, to the original problem, which was x minus 1 equals 5. The solutions were 6 and negative 4. And we show that those really are true. Now, in general, this is the way we could do it algebraically always. If you have some stuff inside the absolute value and you have some number over here that is positive, you know this stuff inside could either equal k or it could be negative k to make it true. So Anytime you have some stuff, whatever it is, take that stuff, whatever it is, in there, and it gets to equal k, or the stuff inside is equal to negative k. And we're going to solve problems like this on the next video. And I've only done problems where k is 0, but we'll discuss if k is 0 or if k is negative as well.